I'm Sarah O'Connor. I work at the John Innes Center, and we're interested in understanding how plants make anti-cancer agents. So there are a number of plant-derived medicines that have played a huge role in medicine. So another spectacular example is a molecule called Taxol, which is isolated from the yew tree, and this is also used to treat a variety of cancers. One of the problems with plant natural products, and I think the reason why we don't see more of them in the clinic, is that they are expensive and difficult and very time consuming to develop. So there's a very long process between identifying a plant that has some sort of medicinal activity, figuring out what molecule is made by that plant that has the biological activity, and then developing an industrial process for obtaining that molecule to get it into clinical trials and then get it ultimately into the clinic. So I hope that if we develop better and faster ways of understanding the metabolism of plants, we'll be able to exploit these molecules much, much more quickly. So one big project in our lab is looking at a medicinal plant called Madagascar periwinkle. And this is a plant, it's native to Madagascar, though it's spread across the world in the last 500 years or so. And it's used as a source for an anti-cancer agent known as vinblastine, which is known to successfully treat a variety of different cancers. Vinblastine works by binding to a molecular target in the cell. Vinblastine is a small molecule, and it recognizes a specific site on a protein called tubulin. Tubulin is a protein in the cell that's known to polymerize to form something called microtubules. And microtubules are essentially the skeleton of the cell. When vinblastine binds to tubulin, that process of assembly into microtubules is halted, it's inhibited. So particularly when cells need to undergo mitosis, if the cytoskeleton comprised of microtubules can't form, that mitotic process is disrupted and the cells die. So vinblastine acts by inhibiting microtubule formation and causing rapidly dividing cells to die. Vinblastine is fairly expensive. Vinblastine is about $200,000 per kilo. There's another analog of vinblastine called vincristine, which is even more expensive. That's, I believe, about $500,000 a kilo. So one of the things that we'd like to do is to come up with ways of making vinblastine less expensive. A big goal in our laboratory is to identify all of the genes involved in vinblastine biosynthesis. And once we have all of those so-called parts, our hope is that we can put all of those parts, those genes together in a simpler organism like baker's yeast, and then have baker's yeast be able to produce vinblastine. So rather than isolating it from the plant, we can produce it in a simple microbial organism. Identifying the genes that make up plant metabolic pathways is a tough problem. 15 years ago, we were really the only option that we had was to grind up plant tissue and just try to isolate the enzymes from that plant tissue, and it was a nightmare. Things have gotten a lot easier now in that we now have a whole array of genomic and sequence resources for plants. And so we can use an approach called RNA-seq, in which we sequence all of the messenger RNA of plants. So we sequence all of the genes that are actually expressed and going to be turned into proteins. And we can also track the expression levels of each one of those genes in various different parts of the plant and different plant tissues. And by looking at the patterns of expression and assuming that all parts of the pathway have very similar profiles or patterns of expression across these different tissues, that gives us a big clue in being able to identify genes that are likely responsible for the missing steps of vinblastine biosynthesis. Natural products, very often they're very active on their own, but natural products that are produced in plants are often called privileged scaffolds. And that means that the basic structure of the molecule is a very good scaffold for harboring biological activity. Now, sometimes just because it's good at binding tubulin, for example, doesn't make it a good drug. So sometimes by making very small changes to the structure of the molecule, you can get something that's a much better pharmacological agent. So it might have a better half-life in the body. It might have fewer side effects and so on. And so we would really like to explore metabolic engineering approaches to be able to introduce subtle changes into the structures of molecules like vinblastine. And so what we hope is that with our yeast strain, we would be able to, for example, feed the yeast unnatural starting materials. The biosynthetic enzymes would take up those unnatural starting materials to ultimately make an unnatural product. We could also think about mixing and matching pathway enzymes. So for example, we could take a biosynthetic enzyme from, say, some bacterial natural product pathway and mix it in with our vinblastine biosynthetic enzymes and see what kinds of new molecules we can get by really sort of mixing up nature's building blocks in new ways.